The older I get, the more I find myself attracted to the dark side of gingerbread. I no longer like those wimpy, mild, overly sweet gingerbread cakes, but I want something with a little bitterness, with a peppery punch. I want something with a little guts, if you know what I mean.
The dark side is so much more fun.
It really is.
We're gonna make a beautiful layer, special occasion gingerbread cake. Lots of ginger flavor, and we're gonna emphasize those flavors you mentioned, right? So I have here 1 3/4 cups of all-purpose flour, not cake flour, we want some structure here. And I have 1 1/2 teaspoons of baking powder and 3/4 teaspoon of salt. Now this is just the plain dry ingredients. Gonna whisk these together. Now let's add our flavor. Of course, ginger. This is 2 tablespoons of powdered ginger.
Oh, you didn't hold back.
We didn't hold back. This isn't the only ginger component, but this is our start. So we're gonna get our warmth from cinnamon. This is 1 teaspoon of ground cinnamon. Now, for heat and floral notes, this is white pepper. So it has a very similar component as ginger does. This is 1/2 teaspoon of white pepper. You see some recipes use black pepper, but we really like that floral component of the white pepper. And 1/8 teaspoon of cayenne pepper.
A little punch.
Yeah, well think about ginger. When you bite into fresh ginger, it really has that punch. One more component here, and it's cocoa powder. Not a lot, this is 1/4 cup, so it's not gonna turn it into a chocolate cake. Of course, it's going to add beautiful color to the cake. And a little bit of bitterness, but it's also a starch, so it's gonna wick away any excess moisture that's in the cake, so it's gonna be easier for us to decorate and layer later on.
Oh, so it's a tenderizer.
Exactly. And I'll just whisk this together. All right, so let's take a look at our liquid ingredients here. We are using molasses as a base, but on its own, it really didn't have the complexity of flavor that we were looking for in our cake. So we're going to augment, this is 3/4 cup of molasses, with 1 cup of brewed coffee that's just cooled down a little bit, 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda. Of course, it's going to help with leavening, but it's doing another thing. It's going to neutralize the acids of the molasses just a little bit to temper it so that we don't get a tangy ginger cake. We want a nice, robust ginger cake. Stir this together. Now let's add our rest of our ingredients to the wet side here. This is 3/4 cup of vegetable oil. We're not creaming any butter or using melted butter. We love the plush texture of vegetable oil, plus it's neutral flavor. So it's gonna let that ginger flavor shine through.
Yeah, we often like vegetable oil in hearty flavored cakes like chocolate cakes because it doesn't obscure the flavor.
Exactly. All right, we have 1 1/2 cups of granulated sugar, 3 eggs that I've beaten, and 2 tablespoons of grated fresh ginger. Kapow.
Wow. That's gonna be good.
We're putting the ginger in gingerbread. So I'll whisk all this together. All right, so that looks good. It's all incorporated, and I'm gonna pour this right into our beautiful dry ingredients here. I'm gonna whisk these 2 together just until they're smooth.
Now, is there any worry about over-whisking this batter?
No, because I am not an electric mixer. You would have to spend all day here getting this too tough. That looks good. So now we are making a 4-layer cake. We're gonna bake the cakes in 2 batches of 2, so there's 4 layers total. Now these are 2 8-inch pans. You wanna grease and flour them, and then you just add a little bit of parchment on top. So now 1 1/3 cup goes into each of these pans. I'll do 1 cup in each and then go back and add the 3rd. All right, so 3rd cup. So it's not a lot of batter into each of these.
It really is a very thin layer of batter. Obviously, it'll bake up to be a thicker cake, and when you put 4 of them on top of each other, that's a pretty looking 4-layer cake.
It is. That is our first 2 layers. These are going to go into a 350-degree oven. You wanna bake them on the middle rack. We're gonna keep them in there for 12 to 14 minutes, but what I'm looking for is a toothpick inserted in the center. It comes out clean. In the meantime, we can get started on the frosting.
Ooh, in a saucepan.
It's called ermine frosting. And a lot of people think that this was the original frosting for another old-fashioned cake, the red velvet cake.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah, it's luxurious, it's fluffy, it's white. And we're getting a head start on this because this is not a last-minute frosting. So we've got 1 1/2 cups of granulated sugar. Now, here is our thickener. This is 1/4 cup of all-purpose flour. And to help this along, we also have 3 tablespoons of cornstarch. This was actually a surprise to me. When you use all flour, it can taste a little floury. So we're gonna have all the thickening power from the cornstarch without that flour flavor. And then 1/2 teaspoon of table salt. So I'll take my whisk and just mix these up, getting up any lumps of flour or cornstarch at this point. Now we're gonna turn it into a pudding. This is 1 1/2 cups of milk. Gonna gradually add it in there.
And the heat's still off at this point.
Exactly. Just trying to get rid of any lumps in here. Now that I've got this going, I'm gonna add the rest of this. I'll switch over to my spatula. Seek and find the bottom. Any lumps down there? Looking good. So now I'm gonna turn it to medium heat. Now I'm gonna switch back to the whisk. There we go. I'm going to whisk this constantly, really going into those corners, the sides, and the bottom of this pan. Now this is going to start to boil, and that's good. And eventually it's going to thicken. That's gonna take about 5, maybe 7 minutes.
Ooh, that thickened up so well.
You can see this looks really thick. That's correct. So this is thick enough. I'm gonna move it over here. We want it to stop cooking. This is going to hang out, cool down at least 2 hours before we move on to the next step. Let's go back to our cakes, which have cooled for 10 minutes. So we're going to invert these out of the pans. I like to use my hand here, and I'll get rid of the parchment at this point. All right, so now I'm going to re-invert these. Just like that. So now it's batch number 2. I'm going to wipe these clean, these 2 pans here. Some more baking spray parchment in the bottom. Another 1 1/3 cups of batter in each pan, then back in that 350 oven for 12 to 14 minutes. All right, it's time to finish our frosting. Mm. There's butter in the house. This is 3 sticks or 24 tablespoons of unsalted butter that are nice and soft. We're gonna beat this with the paddle beater on medium high until it's nice and light and fluffy. That's gonna take about 5 minutes.
That looks good and creamy.
Creamy, light, and fluffy. So I'm gonna scrape down the butter. Now we're going to add in our cooled pudding mixture, our gel. We have a little bit of vanilla extract. 2 teaspoons there. This is going to go back on the mixer. I'm going to turn the mixer back to medium just until it's combined. And after that, I'll scrape down the sides of the bowl, crank it up to medium high. We're going to let this go until it's really fluffy. That's going to take about 3 to 5 minutes. Now, it might look a little curdled. Sometimes it does look a little curdled around 3 minutes. It then smooths out, and it's going to be unbelievable. Oh, yeah.
That looks beautiful.
Isn't that incredible? So now we're going to use a turntable here. I've got a cardboard round. It's gonna make it easy later on to just move the cake. Now I do wanna anchor this cardboard round. There we go. Just helps a little bit. Still gonna slide, but that's okay. Let's get our first layer up there. They're completely cooled.
I mean, these look amazing. They are perfectly flat.
Now, one of the keys of making a layer cake is to measure out the amount of frosting between each layer. We're gonna use 3/4 cup of the frosting. I'm gonna switch over to my larger offset, and I'm gonna start from the middle and just spread the frosting out till it's almost at the edges. Really, when you're frosting a cake, you're just pushing it. What I'm doing now is I'm just evening it out, using the turntable to do that.
Gorgeous.
All right, we'll add the second layer. Another 3/4 cup of frosting on this layer.
That looks pretty, and it's not even fully frosted.
We're gonna keep on going with this third layer and another 3/4 cup of frosting.
Last layer.
So I'm just pressing down just to get it even, because this is really my last chance. I am gonna start at the top again. So again, you wanna start to go over to the edge and then let it fall over the edge. Now, for those sides, what I like to do is I like to use the back of my offset. You can start at the bottom and push it right against the cake. Basically, I'm getting a crumb coat here and just filling up any little pockets that don't have frosting. And I always tell people, if it starts to get a little bit runny, you can always go ahead and put the cake and the frosting in the fridge for just a few minutes. You actually don't want to do it too long because it will set up. And this is one of these frostings that they use a lot in the South because it's so humid. It will actually withstand a hot barbecue.
Ooh. Yeah.
Yes, you got a cake, you don't want it to weep and wilt. This is the frosting for you. All right, so that is the skim coat. Now I'm going to scrape all of that frosting into one area so that I can keep going over this until it's nice and smooth.
Bridget, you know your stuff when it comes to cakes.
You know, and I kind of went to a little bother with this, trying to get it smooth. But the thing about ermine frosting is it's very fluffy. You're never going to get it positively smooth, so just don't worry about it. Now I'm going to turn this top into a little bit of a spiral. Just start right in the middle and turn the turntable. And as you turn it, you just work your spatula out.
More ginger.
More ginger. This is candied ginger, and we chopped it up. You want to use about a quarter cup, but use as much as you like. I like to just go around those sides because those sides are never the prettiest part of a cake. So I'm going to finish this off, and then we're going to put it in the fridge. Needs to set up just for a little bit, chill down, about 30 minutes. You can actually make this cake up to 2 days in advance.
Ooh, I like make ahead.
I'm still inspecting it.
I noticed.
It was in the fridge for 30 minutes, and then I transferred it to this beautiful cake platter. It's a special occasion. In we go with a knife. Now, it's a good idea to let this come to room temperature before you eat it. The frosting and the cake are just much more flavorful that way. I'm gonna dip my knife into hot water over here. Got it in a pitcher.
This is always a good idea whenever you're cutting into a tall layer cake because the hot water warms the knife up and cleans it so you get nice clean slices.
Exactly. And then I just dried it off by wiping it on a paper towel. No skimpy slice here.
I was going to say, I like your slice style.
All right. There we go.
Look how even the frosting is between those layers. Let's see how it tastes. Mm-hmm. Oh, it's got ginger, and then it's sweet, and then there's molasses.
Just that little bit of cocoa, too, it adds kind of another dimension. It's almost like a spice itself. I want you to just taste the frosting. Tell me what you think of that. It's not too sweet.
No, it's delicious. Mm-hmm. This cake is amazing. Thank you.
You bet.
So if you want to make a really hearty gingerbread cake, start with two big mixing bowls. In one bowl, whisk together flour, dried ginger, white pepper, and cayenne. And in the other, whisk molasses, coffee, vegetable oil, and eggs. Whisk the wet and dry ingredients together, then bake in batches to make four identical cake layers. Frost with the classic ermine frosting and refrigerate for at least 30 minutes before serving. From our test kitchen to your kitchen, a killer recipe for gingerbread layer cake. I'm serious, I'm a total convert now. Chocolate's out, gingerbread's in. Thanks for watching America's Test Kitchen. What'd you think?
Well, leave a comment and let us know which recipes you're excited to make, or you can just say hello.
You can find links to today's recipes and reviews in the video description.
And don't forget to subscribe to our channel.
See you later.
I'll see you later.